Agreed or not? Then change a variable. What? M minus N, J minus K is P, acha, K plus P. Which I can write it as sigma p rxx m minus n minus p into sigma p hk plus p hk. First I do summation on p. So you will end up into k, something on k, then this k is brought here and summation on, I'm sorry, this is k. First sum on k. M minus?
N plus
P. Plus P, is it? Okay. Are you sure? Ah, okay. And what about this? Hk is okay. Hj is equal to what is j equal to? K plus P. Okay, this is okay. Is that all right? So now here I sum over k, it will be a function of p, whatever I get here I substitute here, multiply this sum over p. And what is the second part equal to? What kind of form is this? This is also a correlation function of the of the response hk. If you call this as some rho, so you end up into a very simple expression that ryy so this is the autocorrelation function of the output random variables, two random variables separated at a distance equal to m minus n in terms of the correlation function of the input random variables, assuming the input random variables are white and stationary. This is the cross correlation between x and y of two random variables separated by distance m minus n in a white and stationary scenario comes out to be equal to this m minus n. So these are very important results in the process in the transmission of random variables through a linear time invariant discrete system. We will come back to this after a few minutes. And let us do something else and come back. Okay. Any r, let us say xx, has some m minus n because it is a stationary process, Weissen stationary. So let me call this as in terms of some n which is equal to m minus n, some number, which by definition is equal to difference is equal to n. So I define these are some numbers with index of n. I take these numbers and take multiply v to the power of j omega n and sum them up. And this is what does it remind you? Remind you like a Fourier transform? Right? So it is like a Fourier transform of this correlation function. So this is called a spectral density. This is spectral density of the process X. So if I now take the Fourier transform on this by this definition, I should be able to express the spectral density of y in terms of spectral density of x. So it tells me how this black box here transforming the spectral density of the input to the spectral density of the output. What does the Fourier transform indicate? What is the concept of Fourier transform? We are expressing the function in terms of sinusoids, right? And they are orthogonal sinusoids. That means the power or energy in that waveform is now distributed in different frequencies. The amount of power associated with each one of these is what is constitute the Fourier transform. That is why we call it spectral density. And if you sum up all this, you should be able to get the total amount of power. So people use the word power spectral density. That is by definition given by this. This is originally called Wiener-Kinzig theorem, that the correlation function of spectral density is related by a Fourier transform. Very powerful result, we will use extensively. Anyway, leave that aside, this is a definition, let us say, given by this. If I now write this differently, does it ring a bell? Nothing but the Z transform of this sample values of the correlation function, but this is obtained by evaluating the Z value equal to e to the power of j omega, not minus j omega. Because Z transform is defined with respect to minus n, Z minus n. So this is j omega. So what I am saying is that spectral density is obtained by taking the Z transform and substituting Z is equal to e to the power of j omega.